In this video, we're going to discuss two more problems in which we will find the antiderivative, well, the definite integral in this video, of hyperbolic functions. So the first example will be to find the antiderivative, the definite integral from 0 to 1 of cosh x times e to the sinh x dx. So using the u substitution, u is equal to sinh x. So whenever you have the e, you know that the power of that e will be the u substitution here. Du is equal to cosh x dx. Okay? Which is conveniently there for you, right? Cosh x dx. So the du is already there and the e to the u is there as well. Now one thing remains to do is to change the limits of integration, because now you're changing your variable, right? So u as a function of x, when x is equal to 0, the lower limit, u is equal to sinh of 0, right? And sinh of 0 is 0. U as a function of x when x is equal to 1 is equal to sinh 1, right? Plug in the x, sinh 1. So now you're going to have from 0 to 1, well, from 0 to sinh of 1, right, because you're changing the variable to u. So e to the u, and then cosh x dx is du, right? So then we will have e to the u integrated from 0, right, the definite integral evaluation using the first fundamental theorem of calculus, right, sinh 1. So that will give us e to the sinh 1 minus e to the 0, right? E to the 0 is just 1. Okay, so that's your definite integral value. The second example is a little bit more complicated. It's going to be from 0 to 1, and the function will be, the hyperbolic composite function, you can say, will be cosh of 2x divided by 3 plus sinh 2x dx. Okay, so in this case, the u substitution, we're going to choose 3 plus sinh 2x, right? Because we know that the derivative of sinh is going to be the cosh. That's why we know that the bottom should be the u. Du is going to be 0 plus cosh 2x times the inside, which is 2, right? So it's just 2 cosh 2x dx. Okay, also we're going to change the limits of integration. U as a function of x when x is equal to 0, u is equal to 3 plus sinh 2 times 0. Sinh of 0 is 0, right? So 3 plus 0 is just 3, right? U as a function of x when x is equal to 1, we'll get 3 plus sinh of 2, right? 2 times 1 is 2. So it's just 3 plus sinh of 2. And 3 plus sinh of 2 is greater than 3, so we're doing okay, right? We're still getting consistency in terms of having the upper limit and lower limit of integration. Okay, so now let's see what we're going to do. So we're gonna write these guys as they are. Cosh, well, actually, I should have more space for my upper limit. So 3 plus sinh 2. Right, that's the upper limit, and the lower limit is 3. And the integrand, let's just write cosh 2x. And let's write this 3 plus sinh 2x as u. And then the dx will be what? We can write this dx as du divided by the 2 cosh 2x, right? If we solve it for dx, right? So it's going to be 2 cosh 2x. Oh, wait a second, what am I doing? Times du over 2 cosh 2x, right? 2 cosh 2x, right? Because basically what we did, we substituted the dx for du divided by 2 cosh 2x. Okay, so now notice that the cosh 2x cancels out, which is what we need, and we only have 1 half left that we can put outside the integral. Okay? So we get 3 plus sinh 2, and we get 1 over u du. And that should be easy now because the antiderivative of 1 over u is ln. So we're going to have 1 half ln. Now, are we going to need the absolute value for the ln input? No. Why? Because the 3 plus sinh 2 is greater than 0. It's positive. And 3 is also positive, right? So we just need ln u, right? Regular u without absolute value. Integrated from 3 to 3 plus sinh 2. So that will give us 1 half ln of 3 plus sinh 2 minus 1 half of ln 3. So there you go. That's your definite integral value. I hope that you found this video useful. Please subscribe to my channel and I'll see you in my next video.